द जर्नी ऑफ साधका इज लाइक अ माउंटेन क्लाइंबर. जस्ट विजुअलाइज दिस. यू गो टू द हिमालयन बेस कैंप, यू विल सी थाउजेंड्स ऑफ पीपल ऑल वेटिंग एट द बेस कैंप. दे जस्ट एंजॉयिंग द ग्लोरी ऑफ बींग नेक्स्ट टू माउंट एवरेस्ट. दे वॉच लुक अप द पीक. ओ आई विश हाउ कुड यू नो क्लाइंब अप देयर. बट इट टेक्स अ लॉट ऑफ करेज, इट टेक्स लॉट ऑफ मनी, इट टेक्स अ लॉट ऑफ प्रिपरेशन, रेडीनेस एंड अ होल लॉट ऑफ यू नो अलाउंस टू मेक इट हैपन. So now, at the base camp, as you see, a lot of people, but they are looking up to the peak as a, how can we reach there? What does it take to reach there? Is it just the longing or an intense intent, which is called Sankalpa Shakti? So we all have that Sankalpa Shakti. That's called purpose and driven by intent. Once the purpose and intent come together, they marry each other, then there is a possibility that the means will also follow. The strong purpose, means will also follow. That means what are the, we are trying to address the means first and then come to the purpose. That's why our calling of the Kundalini is not strong enough. That's why there is so much resistance. Because what if I become aware and I look at my wife and she looks like my sister? That means there is so much fear place that we can't even visualize that knowingness, that the soul has no relationship. It has only a connection. And Kundalini is the connection to the highest source. It's not even a relationship. All we focus in our life was we have relationships. And we are scared we will lose our relevance to this universe. And this relevance is by identity of the soul, which is so entrenched in that drama, it cannot dislodge from that state. It has constantly keep validating itself that it has a job, it has a certain social identity, a social stigma, a particular status, and not a stature. Remember this. We are not focused on the stature, the state of being. We are focused on the status. So obviously, if the status gets shaken up, what if you become aware everybody around you looks ordinary? Yes, that's why if you go to a party, if you're a teetotaler and you're sitting in a bunch of drunken friends, they don't like you because you're watching them with intent eyes. You can see through them. Same way, the witness within can watch the drama happening. So if the witness becomes pure, undisturbed of the highest knowing, the Shakti becomes more intensified, saying that yes, I know the Mithya, the illusion, and the Satya is that you are not this body, you are not this mind, you are not this thinking process. You, who are you then? You are a powerful being in a human journey. So how long does it take for this journey to happen? So in the cosmic context, this entire human journey is not even a nanosecond, according to Brahmakalpa. So if we all realize that, how, but this long passage of this time capsule that we are going to have a long 100 years old innings, well, through this journey of slow drawn process from birth to death. So what happens when we actually calibrate is that this concept of time, space, gravity will eventually become more and more conducive for us to move towards timing. There's a difference between time and timing. So what is the right time? You don't know what's the right time. Who invented the first clock and what was the first time set with the clock? Did you look up the sun and ask what's the time? The same way, the people say, what is the right time for me to start this journey? When is the right date? There is no such thing as date and time. You have to look at the timing. For the timing to happen, it's called synchronicity or samyoga. So the first ability for us to drop the fear of what this body is, whether this body is a time device, yes, it is a time device with a number of breaths. It is, but the qualitative aspect of this is we are moving from ignorance, avidya, to vidya. But the only troublesome aspect is this, our viveka is dislodged. The discriminative intelligence is shaky. We are not sure whether we are going to be, we have put our feet on two boats. The wind direction shifts, one boat moves this side, you're going to do split, eventually lose one of the boats. So that means a fear of not being able to balance our own journey. So the yoga sadhana is about balance. So if these two are balanced, the force is coming into the center, but it is not having enough firepower to rise. And only thing that can rise is by dropping the immense fear of what next. The assumption of tomorrow, what tomorrow can do to you. Whether we are qualitatively aware that you have come here on an eternal holiday and an expression of the purest knowingness that we are divine beings and nothing is going to hurt us, nobody is going to hurt us, and we are passing through this beam, passing through the sun into this planet and just exiting out of this. This blue dot, this earth is, and in that blue dot, in the smallest blue dot is Shambhala, the connection to the Shyamabala, and in that the awakened state is accessing these higher beings, and this whole Kundalini Shakti becomes so intensely beautiful that there is no struggle of trying to make it happen. Because how is it possible that you're going to train the magnet to attract? You don't have to train the magnet to attract. Magnetic property is already inside. Do you have to train the river how to flow? No. So now where is the struggle then? If the river wants to flow because its inherent nature is to flow and merge with the ocean, there is an emergence, there is a flow and convergence. Emergence, flow, convergence. So who is coming in the way? And why is that the magnetic power head is weak? It's because we have focused elsewhere. We are out of focus. We have become hazy. We are standing in the fog. We don't even know what next. So even the clarity is possible only by purity. And that process is that of Shuddhi Karana. Karma Kshalana, Nadi Shodhana, Klesha Shodhana, and Samskara Shuddhi, Vritti Shuddhi, Prana Shuddhi, Chitta Shuddhi, Antarkarana Shuddhi. They sound very like as if it's some rocket science, but it is actually nothing but purification of our impressions in the form of bio memories, all the toxin that we have built up and stored in all our joints, in our muscles, in our tissues, in our bio memory, in the brain, everywhere it is just stuck as incompleteness, fractured aspect of us. Now, how can we dissolve this fragmented aspect? How can we come out of this limitation place that is often tormenting us by being a sense of separation which is so supremely strong?